سيدي السلام عليك يا نبي العربي.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين. All the praise and all the glory is due to Allah, and I bear witness that there is no God but Allah and that Muhammad is his last prophet and messenger. There is a very important statement which says, land does not glorify or commemorate people, but people who add those commemorations and glorifications for the land. Here on this site, the Messenger of Allah, blessings and peace of Allah be upon him, was part in one of the greatest dilemmas in the whole of his life. This is the side of the Battle of Uhud, the second battle after Badr, where the disbelievers of Mecca, following the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam and trying to get rid of the whole of Islam, and they are actually exerting all possible efforts coming to the Medina. We have actually a valley which is surrounded by two basic mountains. This great mountain is called the Mountain of Uhud, and it is a very great landmark in the history of Islam. There is just a hadith about the Mountain of Uhud, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, Uhud jabalun yuhibbuna wa nuhibbu. The mountain of Uhud is a mountain that we love and it loves us. And once the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam was standing on Uhud with Abu Bakr, Umar and Uthman, and it shaked, so the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, be firm, because you have a prophet, a martyr, or two martyrs and one trustworthy on you. So we have the Mountain of Uhud. The place that we are standing on is called the Mountain of Ar-Ruma, and Ar-Ruma are the people who had arrows, and the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam delegated them with a task or a job that we are talking about right now. And in the middle, this is a valley where the Battle of Uhud has already occurred. Let me describe for you easily. The Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam came with his companions from Medina. They were actually 1,000 people. 700 of them left the arena, and most of them, they were the hypocrites who did not join the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Messenger camped here on this valley, and he came before the disbelievers of Mecca. The Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam chose a strategic place. He is protected by the whole mountain of Uhud, and here he also appointed 50 people of the Prophet's companions, and they are called Ar-Ruma, the people who are very clever in archery and in arrows. And he told them that you must protect our backs. They are supposed to sit on this mountain, the Mountain of Ar-Ruma. Imagine, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam told him a very eloquent statement. He said, you must keep standing, protecting our backs. Do not leave your place. Even if you see birds snatching our corpses and bodies, if you see all the disbelievers running away from us, do not leave your place. The Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam left no room for reasoning, no room for personal opinions. He said, if you see us gaining victory against those people, never ever leave your place. And I need actually to concentrate on this statement of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The disbelievers came from this direction. This is the direction of Mecca. They tried to join the army of the disbeliever, of the believers. They had 3,000 people fully armed with horses and camels. They even brought their women, their slaves, all of their supporters, with one goal and for one mission, which is to get rid of Muhammad, his companions, and of whole the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Khalid ibn al-Walid was the leader of the army. He tried to study the whole area to find a gap or a place to control the believers, but unfortunately or fortunately he could not, because the archery were actually on the mountain protecting the back of the believers. How the battle started? It was here in the middle. The Prophet, usually the battles at that age started by individual fighting. So the believers and the disbelievers try to meet together. First, there is a family which is called Abd al-Dar. They dedicated 10 people among them, carrying the slogan or the flag for the disbelievers. All the 10 were actually killed at the beginning. So it was a warning against the disbeliever and a sign that Allah granted initial victory for the Muslims. Even it is reported after starting the fighting and engaging in a lot of troubles with the Muslims, they could not take any opportunity to fight against the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam or his companions, until they tried to run away, leaving the vanities of this dunya, leaving their families and leaving their children and their women. Even one of the Sahaba, one of the companions, said, I saw the slave girls of Hind, the wife of Abu Sufyan, running away. Even her husband and her people left everything and they tried to run, aiming to Mecca. On that spot, the believers were here on this mountain. They were protecting and implementing the command of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They saw the disbelievers running away, leaving the dunya, the vanities of this life, because it is so difficult to carry gold, to carry silver, and to carry sheep, and to carry their children and their families with them. The believers saw that and they said, let us leave our place, let us run after them, take some of the booties of war. Abdullah ibn Jubayr, and he was the leader of the 50 people on that mountain, he said, no, you are not supposed to leave your place, because the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam gave us a decisive command not to leave the place. Even if we see birds taking or snatching our heads. So they tried to quarrel with him, and they found actually almost 10 people who remained staple on that mountain. Han and the rest took all the booty, the spoils of war, and they tried to take some of the vanities of this life. So Abdullah and his people tried to fight. Khalid ibn al-Walid came from the other side of the mountain and he tried to take hold of that mountain, that small. You see, it's a very small mountain, but it's very strategic and it's very important, because when a person stands on that mountain, he can see the whole site and he can shoot anybody here in the arena. So the man said to his people, don't leave your place. The Prophet ﷺ has already commanded us not to leave the place. They refused. They ran away. And Abdullah ibn Jubayr stood firm on his mountain. Khalid ibn al-Walid came from the other side, fought against him, and he could get a control on the strategic site here, trying to shoot arrows against the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam and his companions. In fact, it was a very difficult situation. The combat was intense, and the disbelievers could recognize the place of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. They could know where he is in the arena, and they started shooting him. And this, it was a very difficult situation. The Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam on that stage, he was calling upon the believers. Some of the believers actually at that battle, they ran away here in the right side or in the left side. Some of them even kept holding or kept trying to climb over the mountain of Uhud. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about it in the Quran, إِذْ تُصْعِدُونَ وَلَا تَلْوُونَ وَالرَّسُولُ يَدْعُوكُمْ فِي أُخْرَاكُمْ. You are running and climbing up the mountains, leaving the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam on the backside of the army. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam was calling upon the Ansar, upon the Muhajireen to support him. And in fact, they did a very great job for the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Here in that situation, they showed great sacrifice for the Prophet and Messenger. Blessings and peace of Allah be upon him. On the top of them, Mus'ab ibn Umair, may Allah be pleased with him. And he's one of the immigrants. Mus'ab ibn Umair, he never left the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam until he was killed. And the people found him at the end of the battle, putting his face on the dirt, as if he is saying, I'm not feeling relaxed until I know that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam is alive. And he was reading and reciting an ayah, which it was not an ayah at that time, but later it was revealed to the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُلُ. And Muhammad is but a messenger before him. All prophets and messengers have already passed away. There are a lot of stories which happened on that place. There are a lot of sacrifices which were made for the sake of Allah, His Messenger, and for the sake of religion. We will continue explaining, inshallah, from an upper side. Jazakum Allahu khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.